J.SCHRECK.
And James.
Myths, legends, and lies. It's up to date, James.
I don't know. I need a new intro, but that's a whole other story.
You could say I'm someone else. I'm not James. I'm someone else.
Sorry, that just popped in my head.
You know, I was thinking about coffee, and I was thinking about, you know, vices, and I was thinking about all kinds of different stuff, because, you know, one thing is, man, I do have to have my coffee. Coffee's a big deal to me today. It really is a big deal. We talk about this a lot, and we're always going to talk about it a lot, because it is a big deal. You know, it's always going to be a main topic, right?
Yeah, it's for those of you that aren't in our lives every day. This is what we start every single day with. It's like me and him get together, go grab coffee. And then start.
And then talk about what's next. And you know what's next is, we dug into this a little bit the other day, and I want to dig a little deeper because I think it's intriguing. I think it's a good topic, and it's called the Lost Dutchman Mafia. Have you ever heard of the Lost Dutchman Mafia?
I have. It might be something that we coined ourselves, but I've heard of it for sure.
Well, you know, there is a, if you have Dutch hunted in your local, what you're going to find out is there's a group of people, right?
Yep.
That are kind of in this circle. And I would say that the true Lost Dutchman Mafia directly is gone, right? I would say that the old school.
The Crazy Jakes and, yeah.
The people that would actually kill you.
Yeah.
The people that would actually physically do harm to you, physically kill you, physically, I mean, would shoot you. Mm-hmm. I mean that. Those guys, I believe, most of those guys are gone.
There's true stories of guys going out, stumbling on stuff, and getting shot. So, yeah,
now,
absolutely.
There might be a few remnants of those guys that are still around. I don't think they would actually go out and shoot you. I mean, I might be wrong. But there was a group of people at one time that operated within the confines of the Lost Dutchman, Superstition Mountains,
yeah.
Right?
They were all from that area, lived in that area, moved there. And, yeah.
That they believed, and there was a core group of people that actually would go in there. Then people knew who they were, and they knew the people. You know, mm-hmm. Tex would be one of the guys that I would say is probably one of the biggest kingpins of that kind of movement. And there was a time where, you know what, nothing happened in those Superstition Mountains without those guys knowing what was going on. And if they did, you know, because again, a lot of the people had to be packed in. Yeah. And then again, there was a lot of lunacy up there, you know, and there's a lot of craziness that was going on up there. Now, you know, let's fast forward into, you know, 2019, right? Big fire that went on up there. We still believe that this is the time that, and I've also had rumors there's people in there right now. I'm not going in there because the, you know, because you're not allowed in there now. But I've heard from my sources that there's people already, you know, moving around in the Superstition Mountains with some connections with some of the different law enforcement, different that are looking around. You know, not say that they're directly or indirectly. I'm just telling you what I heard, right? And that there's still a good old boy club type of deal that's going on out there, even though it might not be mafia.
Well, you know, the power is different now because a lot of the money is geared. We've talked about this in the past. Like, it's a lot more hiking, backpacking. That culture is where the money is now. It's not the Dutchman guys getting packed in on mules. But, I mean, even in our research, when we stumble on, like, a place and we talk to a local, like, we're still asked, well, don't you know this guy? Don't you know that name? Mm-hmm. And we're kind of looked at as, like, outsiders in the Dutch hunter world because we don't, you know, I don't hang out with that guy or that guy. So it is a whole thing, you know what I mean?
Well, and I think it hurts us a little bit because of maybe some of the knowledge, but also the other side of the coin is that my theory is pretty simply this. They haven't found it.
We're not constrained into any, and
if they did, nobody told anybody, and I don't think that. I mean, I've not met a cowboy yet that could be quiet, could keep a secret, right?
Yeah.
Going back to maybe some of the vices, because some of the vices that we carry that we couldn't, there's no way that people would not be able to know that that's what you found.
They like to spin a tail.
So my belief is this, if you guys were so good at what you did, you would have found it. And now that might sound mean to them.
That's confrontational.
But it's the truth, right? And it goes back to the truth, isn't it? You know, you've had your 150 years to find it. Now give somebody else a shot, right?
No, I mean,
so,
yeah.
I mean, I hope young guys go out there. I hope young guys get off the couch. I hope young guys get off the video games. Instead of playing Red Dead Redemption, go play Lost Dutchman Mine. And get out there and experience it. And experience and find the damn thing.
Yeah.
I mean, and I'll put myself in the middle of that group, kind of. You know, I've had my time. You know, mm-hmm. I mean, I have not been able to dig it up yet. I mean, I wish I would have. And I keep thinking I'm going to, but I haven't.
Well, right? Yeah.
So I'm in that group, too. You can categorize me as one of the old school guys, even though I'm not in the old school.
Yeah.
I'm still the old school.
You've been doing it longer than me. Exactly. You know,
so, I mean, I hope, and I'm the guy that wants you to find it. I mean, you know, we do a lot of media stuff on top of that type of stuff. We're just intrigued with the stories. Would I like to find it? Hell yes, I would. But I want somebody to find it. I want it to be real. That's my big deal.
Yeah, you exactly. And for me, it's just kind of interesting. I mean, I like the mystique of the whole thing. I like the idea that, like, what if all these people have been doing this for so long and there is no Dutchman? You know, but I like the idea of going out there and, you know, it started as just an excuse to be in the superstitions. It started as an excuse to do historical research.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the more you read about it, the more you're like, well, something's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, from, you know, the late 1800s till now, people have been determined to find this mm-hmm. thing. And that's a long stretch of a lot of people who have turned up nothing and it being reported.
Well, you know, when Greg and them were hunting that steamship, right?
Mm-hmm.
400 ships crashed on the Missouri-Mississippi rivers. 400
right? Yeah.
Steamboats went down. 400. And so we were supposed to go hunt a boat with them at one time. That was part of the deal. And then tragedy struck. But we were going to go hunt a boat with them.
Oh, okay.
We were in the middle of that. He had... And his name was Greg Holly. He had a bunch, and I'm sure his brother and his dad, they had a bunch of boats spotted, right, that they were going to go try to dig up or try to find or try to figure out. All through history, right, by doing the history, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And so that stuff's real. I mean, it's real.
Oh,
they've been trying to clean stuff up now for the last 20 or 25 years, whatever it was. It was the 80s, I believe, sometime in the 80s when they found the original boat, the Arabia.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And so that stuff's true. It's out there. Now, that's not every legend, but eventually, though, if you follow it and you believe it, and they went through documentation. Now, the problem with the Dutchman is a lot of it's hearsay. A lot of it's stories. A lot of it is not documented where you can actually put it down on paper. Now,
yeah.
One thing that we can document is that a lot of people lost their lives looking for the Lost Dutchman gold
mm-hmm.
due to the fact that there was a Lost Dutchman mafia. There's no doubt there were hitmen out there. And not like you think in the old terms, you know, not like you think of a hitman, right, back in the, you know, the
but
Prohibition
days. If you stumbled up to the wrong camp,
yeah,
it is documented that someone shot at you, and some of those guys got hit by those shots.
Yeah,
exactly.
And that's documented. There were people that were killed out there, whether it be Adolph Ruth or whoever. I mean, there's documented deaths out there of people that, so that's the proof to me that there was a Lost Dutchman mafia, you know? Because it was multiple people in multiple generations. It wasn't just like in the frame of like 5 years.
Yeah,
it was 50
it's a
years.
Long stretch.
You know,
and there's all sorts of other stuff too, because you get into, like, you know, you can read about all the people who speculate that people involved with certain areas and businesses out there also had connections with, like, the coroner's office
mm-hmm.
and were putting, you know, bodies to lead people in other directions or to draw tourism
mm-hmm.
or to keep that myth and legend alive that there is the Dutchman mm-hmm. and you should come out and find it. So, I mean, you know, it's a big thing. It's a really interesting little piece of Arizona history that for this long, people have been going out there and bad things happen to them. And then the other half of those people find nothing and
mm-hmm.
have all the maps and they know exactly where to go. And
well, and you know,
nothing comes up. It's interesting.
You know, and everybody's got a theory of where it's at and everybody's got a theory for what it is.
That's
part of
the fun.
That's kind
of
cool.
Yeah,
you know,
that's
their story, right? You know, and we do our research. All of our research is based on what history we do have and what we do believe to be accurate, right? But it doesn't mean that it is. I mean, just like every history. I mean, most history in the West was not accurate. I mean, it was very rare. I mean, you look at all the different people that, you know, the writers that, you know, romanticized the West. Yeah. And, you know, a lot of it was not even close to being true. But, they didn't let truth get in the way of selling newspapers or dime-back novels, right?
So, no, absolutely. The myth of the gunfighter is a perfect example of that. And, you know.
It is so amazing that people still think to this day, if you ask them, that people stood out in the street and sized each other up.
It happened like one time, documented time. Because that's the dumbest way to try to fight a person. Yeah.
Well, not if you really want to survive.
You really want that person dead. So yeah, it's like...
Yeah, it's not
but it makes for awesome movies, it makes for awesome literature, and I get that. But, you know, the reality of the West, which is part of what's fun about what we do, is actually reading about this and realizing, like, yeah, that seems irrational because it was, and most people wouldn't do that.
So if you're going down the trail and you see a guy in a pinstripe suit with a Tommy gun,
you know,
the Lost Dutchman Mafia. So be careful out there.
Watch out.
Is guys. J.SCHRECK.
And James.
This legend. I got to catch James when he's drinking a cup of coffee.
Yeah,
he's like, hey, J.J., something new.